Father, Father, may I come in?
Yes, yes, come in. What's the issue?
Oh, no issue. I just wanted to talk to you about something.
I'm listening.
I was just wondering if maybe when we return home, Velocci and Leonel could maybe start teaching me some guard skills?
Excuse me?
Well, I just want to know how to fight in case...
It's improper for you to learn, Luna.
Anngel is learning, so why can't I?
Because your brother is not a woman. You don't need to learn anyways. Velocci can protect you.
Yes, but I...
Luna! End of discussion!
Yes, Father.
Now, we are almost at Kismet, so I want you on your best behavior.
Yes, Father. Understood.
Good. Now get yourself cleaned up, and I never want to hear about this again.
Nigel, it's so good to see you again.
You as well, Your Highness.
This is my son, Xander.
Pleasure.
Your Majesty, sorry to interrupt, but the Ambassador has arrived and is requesting your presence.
Not now. I'll deal with that later.
Ah, Your Highnesses. My daughter, Lady Luna.
It's a pleasure to finally meet you.
And as to you, my dear, I've heard so much about you.
Lord, should I escort Luna around town?
No, I feel as if the prince should show her around. Wouldn't you agree, Your Majesty?
I think it's a splendid idea.
We shall be on our way then. Follow me.
All right then. It was very nice meeting you.
Likewise.
So what brings you to the kingdom?
My brother had briefly told me that Father had business with the king, but that's all I know.
Ah, I see. I guess they didn't tell you then.
Hmm? What was that?
Oh, nothing. So, how are you liking the kingdom so far?
It's incredible. It's so pretty.
Well, did you know there are approximately 200 ships that dock here every day as well as... never mind.
No, it's fine. I find it interesting that you know so much about this place.
What if I told you this place could be yours?
What?
Well, Luna,
There you are.
Oh, Anngel.
Hello, Luna.
Where's Iris?
Looking around the kingdom. She was very excited to see it.
I can see why.
You get along with the prince, I see.
Yes, His Highness was just showing me around town.
You can just call me Xander, m'lady.
Oh, all right. Xander was showing me around.
I see. We'll take all the time you need. Father is currently talking to the king about some upcoming events. Well, I better be on my way. Have fun, you two.
Farewell, Anngel.
So, where were we?
You were telling me about how all of this could be mine?
Oh, right.
You seem upset about something. Is everything okay?
Yes.
Okay.
Luna?
Yes?
How would you feel if, we were wed?
Excuse me?
No need to worry about your dad or anything. He already agreed to it.
Are you kidding me? I just met you.
I know, but I was just...
I think we're done here, alright?
Oh, alright.
Thank you for the tour, but I must be going now.
Take care, Luna.
Father, are you busy at the moment?
Yes, we are, Luna. What is it that is so important that you have to interrupt?
My apologies for the interruption. I just had a question.
Well, spit it out then.
Father, is it true that the only reason we came to the kingdom was so me and Xander could be wed?
You shall address His Highness as Prince Xander. And yes, that was the intention of this trip.
But why? I don't even know him.
Luna, do not raise your voice with me.
Yes, Father.
Me and the king have already agreed on this. It shall take place whether you like it or not.
I just want to know why.
Because before Xander can take the throne, he needs a bride.
Why does it have to be me?
Because we come from the highest ranked village. Therefore, you are the most fit.
But I...
End of discussion. There is no fighting this, Luna. You will be wed, and you will be on your best behavior.
No, this isn't fair.
Life isn't fair, you disobedient.
Lord Nigel, my lord, was that necessary?
Lady Iris, I didn't know you were here.
Though I do see why the wedding must take place, I don't see why you had to hit her.
I'm sorry you had to see that.
Run along now.
She never listens.
She doesn't listen because she doesn't understand. Perhaps look at things from her perspective every once in a while.
You're right. I apologize.
Please, don't be so hard on her.
I try not to be. She just...
You should know that His Highness is getting the best doctor in town to look after me.
After Luna's wedding, I need to talk to Anngel about his.
Oh, you know him. He wants to wait till the baby is born.
I guess so. My son did a fine job picking you as his wife.
You're too kind. I must be going now. Anngel wants me to meet a housewife who might be able to help with the birth.
Take care, Iris.
You as well, my lord.
Luna?
Go away!
Please, I just want to talk.
What do you want?
I just wanted to apologize for earlier.
Look, Xander, you're a great person, but I can't be your bride. I don't know you, nor do I have feelings for you.
It's okay. I feel the same way.
What?
I'm in love with someone else.
Then why?
Everyone thinks King Cyrus is my father, but I'm actually the son of farmers.
Why do you pretend to be the prince then?
I don't. I was adopted by the king and his wife. His wife is unable to bear children, so when I was 6 years of age, the king saw that I looked like him and adopted me.
And your parents were just okay with that?
No. My mother was very ill at the time, and we had no money. The king offered to help us in exchange for me. At first, my parents didn't allow it, but to protect my mother, I decided to go.
But what does this have to do with us getting married?
Cyrus thinks I'm unfit for the throne, so he wants a grandchild to take it. Since your father is close friends with Cyrus and is the highest ranked lord of the entire kingdom, you would be the best fit for a wife.
I don't know what to do.
Neither do I, but we will get through this. I'm sorry you were dragged into this mess.
Why does your father think you're unfit for the throne?
Cyrus seems like a nice man at first, but I promise you that is not the case. He will do anything to get what he wants. He's a manipulative man. There was this accident a few years back where this young lad, I believe his name was Lai? Lai had stolen some bread, and Cyrus wanted to put him to death. I tried to stop him, but in doing so, Cyrus saw me as weak and unfit for the throne.
Oh my god, that's horrible!
Do not trust Cyrus. Wait, tell me you didn't tell your father you didn't want to wed.
I did.
Oh no, Luna, Cyrus can't find out about that. You must go tell your father you changed your mind before he tells him.
What? Why?
Just trust me.
No, I won't go back on my word.
Luna, you don't understand. Just please, I'll figure this out, but for now, you need to pretend you're okay with the wedding.
All right, then. I'll do it.
Good. Follow me. We need to head to the castle straight away.